Hi, this is Wes Fryer with a sermon sketch note for July the 16th, 2017, and this was on Acts 5, verses 17 through 25 by Eric Lawrence. I'll read the verses first. Then the high priest and all his associates, who were members of the party of the Sadducees, were filled with jealousy. They arrested the apostles and put them in the public jail. But during the night, an angel of the Lord opened the doors of the jail and brought them out. "Go, stand in the temple courts," he said, "and tell the people all about this new life." At daybreak, they entered the temple courts, as they had been told, and began to teach the people. When the high priest and his associates arrived, they called together the Sanhedrin, the full assembly of the elders of Israel, and sent to the jail for the apostles. But on arriving at the jail, the officers did not find them there. So they went back and reported, "We found the jail securely locked, with the guards standing at the doors. But when we opened them, we found no one inside." On hearing this report, the captain of the temple guard and the chief priests were at a loss, wondering what this might lead to. Then someone came and said, "Look, the men you put in jail are standing in the temple courts teaching the people." At that, the captain went with his officers and brought the apostles. They did not use force because they feared that the people would stone them. So this message was very encouraging, thinking about the boldness with which we can and should talk about Jesus and share Jesus. Eric started with the statement that the bigger the vision, the bigger the cost. And one of the themes throughout the sermon was that God gives us a big vision, a huge vision, but he promises to bear those costs. Authorities of the early church wanted to intimidate the disciples and Jesus' followers to prevent them from talking about him. And so that was the story that we heard of where the angel appeared and released the apostles. And rather than going into hiding, they chose to move out back to the temple to teach. And so he talked about how sharing the name of Jesus, speaking the name of Jesus, is always a radical act and it bears costs. But truth creates freedom. He told the story of St. Patrick, who was actually in England, but had been imprisoned and anyway chose to return to Ireland and use his freedom to share the gospel. Faith creates force, and we need to never doubt that Jesus wins. The wisdom of Gamaliel was to not oppose God, and that the will of God and the will of Jesus is going to be done. And so the early church wouldn't stop sharing about Jesus, and we need to follow their lead as well and find joy in the Lord, that faith also creates fun. And so we can seek, although there's no guarantees about this, and this isn't said, as Eric mentioned, in any way to diminish the sacrifices and the sufferings and so many things that have and continue to be done by the people of God. But we should find joy in the Lord and joy in the service of the Lord, and even humor as we can in the story of the angel opening up the gates and the disciples finding themselves set free to immediately go back and being told not to share Jesus. So I found this to be very encouraging and invite you to open up your Bible to Acts 5, verses 17 through 25, and read these words yourself.